しニッポン、I'm キャリーパミュパミュ。
And I'm Ray Master Giovanni, program host for もしもしニッポン。So Gary, it's the、はい、time for the coming of age festival、うん、in Japan. You became of age, it's 20、うん、in Japan, right? Last year.
2年前かな、先
生。2 years ago?
はい。
Oh, okay, okay. How did you spend it? What did you do?
私は来たのは、特注でお着物を作っていただいて、ユニコーン柄のお着物を着ました。
ユニコーンシェイプ、
そう、ショッキングピンクで
、wow.
なんか日本の着物って結構その鶴とか、
okay.
あの伝統のものが結構入ってたりするんですけど、
right, right.
私はもうちょっと私なりに行きたいなと思って、wow. まあ、人生で一度しかないし目立ちたいなと思ってショッキングピンクのユニコーン柄にしましたね。
wow. Did you have a horn right here?
No, no.
No?
No.
Alright、
はい、
Cool, so take us to the 日本 ABC care.
はい、キーワードは S、スカジャンです。もしもし日本。
もしもし。
South of Tokyo is Kanagawa Prefecture, home to a port town with a U.S. naval base. The town is called Yokosuka, and it's got a vibe all of its own thanks to all the shops catering to U.S. military personnel.This shop has been around for 70 years. Its most popular items are letterman jackets, featuring motifs such as dragons and tigers. These jackets are called Tsukajan. The jacket came about after the Second World War. Items that featured stitched oriental motifs were popular souvenirs for American soldiers stationed in Japan.They also got these motifs stitched onto their own jackets and started the souvenir jacket trend. Fabric trader Kosho & Company was one of the first to hop onto this trend and mass produce souvenir jackets. The gamble paid off, and the souvenir jacket became a must-have item. From the 1970s,Shops near Yokosuka Naval Base began selling used souvenir jackets that found popularity with the Japanese. Fans loved the mix of American and Japanese styles. They now go by the name Tsukajan, which combines Yokosuka with jumper, the Japanese word for jacket.Here, in an older part of Tokyo, is Kosho & Company, today known as Toyo Enterprise. They still make Tsukajan while also selling valuable vintage jackets. Toyo Enterprise has Japan's largest collection of Tsukajan. Let's take a look at some vintage Tsukajan to see how the jacket evolved from the 1940s to the 60s.
もともとあったものがこう合わさって違う国のと国の文化が一つになってまた新しいものができたっていうか、うん、そういうところがやっぱり魅力に感じるところだと思いますね。
Our guide is Tatsuro Matsuyama, who was self-publishing books on Tsukajan before joining the company. First up is the earliest type of Tsukajan.
こちらは40年代、中期から後期に作られたスカジャンの原型といいますか最も古いものになるんですけども、ミリタリーのユニフォームですねの形に近い形になっております。
At the time, motifs were stitched directly onto uniforms brought in by soldiers instead of the current letterman jackets. The back shows the year in which it was taken home as a souvenir.
和装刺繍 の、の職人さんが入れられたものだと思いますね。
Kimono stitch artists have long used a type of sewing machine that has no presser foot. This makes sideways stitching possible. It's the perfect tool for the Tsukajan. Tsukajan from the 40s also feature exposed zippers to prevent the fabric from getting caught in them.
こちら 50年代まあ初期なんですけども、こういったまあ、これは TTS というまあジッパーのメーカーが書いてあるんですが、後にこうどんどん吸収されて消滅してしまっていく、まあ、ジッパーの会社なんですよね。ですのでこれはもう50年代まあ初期のもの。
Unlike the 40s jackets, Sukajan in the 50s kept the zippers covered.
50年代まあ中期ですね、当時武士統制で、コットンというのは、で回らなかったんですが、まあ、50年代中期以降一般にも回るようになりまして、それでこういった、バリエーションが増えたということで。
If you look at the back, you'll see that the Korean Peninsula has been stitched on. This is further proof that it was made in the 50s during the Korean War. In fact,Every vintage Sukajan is closely related to an episode in Asian history. Eventually, the motifs on Sukajan began to grow more diverse.
49って星が書いてあるんですけども、これは1959年にアラスカが49番目の州になった時に作られた記念のスカジャンといいますか。
That helped spread the Sukajan to a number of different countries.
60年代に入って、ベトナム戦争っていうのが起きるんですけど、
That led to the production of Sukajan in Vietnam to meet the demand of US soldiers. These are known by the name Vietjan.
背中には、まあ、こういったベトナムの、まあ、地図ですね、あとこうメッセージがちゃんと書いてありまして、自分は死んだら天国に行くだろう、なぜなら地獄で時を過ごしたからだなんて書いてあるんですけども、すごい生々しいジャケットですね。
From its origins as an item that indicated international situations of Eastern Asia, the Sukajan has constantly evolved over time.
Gary, I've always known and recognized the Sukajans in Japan because I like ska, like jazz, and it sounds like ska jazz, but it's Sukajan. What is your image?
いかついイメージがありますね。
Right, me too, yeah.
なんか今の世代からするとなんかちょっと不良っぽい人が着たりだとか、
right.
私も私服で着るんですけどスカジャン、
oh, you do? Okay.
ちょっと悪そうな感じにスタイリングしたい時に羽織るので、
oh, on purpose.
うん、なんかこうかっこいいイメージが強いですね。
So would you like to see the real スカジャン？
うん、見たい。
Okay, let's check it out. Okay, here it is, Gary.
2つあるのは何ですか？
One is vintage, like the original,、うん、and the other is a replica. Can you tell which is which?
あ、いやもう分かりましたよ、これは。
Really?
ヴィンテージがこっちで、okay. レプリカがこっち。
How do you know?
このデザインがもしヴィンテージであったら、レプリカも絶対入れてるなと思いました。
You are smart. That's cool. Yeah,
でもなんかちょっと最新な感じがする。
Okay, it looks more modern. Like they said in the video,、this embroidery, they could only go sideways. And now you can go straight. But they did the same thing in the replica. They went sideways.
同じこと。刺繍でこんなの作れるのすごいですよね。手間がかかる。
Should I try it on?
Yes!
Yes? Let's do it.
リバーシブル？
Yeah, see, it's got a little...
へぇ、すごい。ホラーですね。
わぁ、おぉ、
また全然変わってる。
Yeah, and I've got a... Oh, dragon.
今日、レイさんも私も黒だから、合いそう。
So, Carrie, unfortunately, you're right. You're wearing the right one. This one is the vintage.
あ、こっちがヴィンテージで。
Yes. And mine is the replica, yes.
へぇ、あ、レイさん似合う。
うっせぇん、really? Good.
似合う、似合う。
Yeah, you look good too.
後ろもこれ一緒？ How's it
that?
あ、すごい再現率。へ
ぇ。Is it the same? So let's check out the rest of the video.
はい。
Today, some Sukajan are particularly popular with women. Here's how it looks reversed.The impish rabbit motif and the hand-drawn aesthetic give this Sukajan an unusually inviting appearance. The jacket's produced by Chikiriya, which takes its name from an old Japanese word for promise. Its goal is to promote a traditional sense of kinship through its items. Chiki Ria's designs are created by Machiko Masuda. She sees herself as a traditional Japanese artist rather than a designer.
日本画家だった人たちとかがお客さんの着物に絵を描いてあげるとか、そういうことを仕事にするようになったんですよね。で、そういう自由さっていうか、こだわらなさ、そういうふうに絵を描いていきたいと思って。
Masuda started by painting designs on clothing as past artists once did. A fashion distributor fell in love with her work, and together they launched Chikiria. Let's see how Masuda creates the old school designs that have won her many fans. We'll be taking a look at the popular rabbit motif on Chikiria Sukajan.
こびてる感じで可愛いとかっていうのはちょっと似合わないっていうか、見る人を笑ってるっていうか、おちょくってるような可愛いだけじゃないよっていうのがいいかなと思うんですよね。
Once the outline is done, she traces it using looser lines.She then scans it to maintain a flavor that can't be recreated with design software. Once the motifs are set, Masuda works on the layout. For this early spring item, she is using cherry blossoms and a frog.
儚いとか小さいものとか弱いものを見逃さないとか、黙ってね、何も語らないで。そういうことが生きっていうんじゃないかなと思うんですよ。
For Masuda, it's all about respecting the traditional definition of cool in a contemporary form. You'll find that sense of cool in this Sukajan too. The sleeves feature similarly colored rabbit motifs that are hard to notice at first glance.Now that we've taken a look at a more feminine type of Sukajan, let's check out some Sukajan from the opposite spectrum. This shop looks pretty metal from top to bottom. It's Rowan from designer and creative director Hiromu Takahara.
のろしっていう言葉を音読みくるみを逆にしたような形のロエンっていうブランドを作ってですね、いろんな国でのろしっていうのが伝達信号である中で、日本から僕は伝達していく。
Takahara made his start at popular shoe brand Alfredo Bannister before going independent in 2001. His works are renowned and have been featured at Milan Fashion Week. Now let's check out a Sukajan he's produced.
刺繍とかも、昔の、手振りの感じのもので、ゴリッとした形のもので、そこでちょっと男っぽさとかを表現しているような形で、大地と空とあとは自分っていう、民族はもともと持ってる考え方っていうのを、3つ合わせて、表現するっていうことが、大体僕がデザインするその絵柄の中には確実に入っててますね。
And reversed?
このサテンの柄とかにも表現しているのが、普通のスタジャンじゃないような形で、まあ、独々しい絵柄が入ってるんだけども、ドット柄で水玉模様に見えるっていう、透明では可愛く見えるけど近くで見ると濃いものが入っているっていうような形のものを作っていますね。
Both sides present completely different worlds created from Takahara's observations.
街歩きながら今流行ってるものを着てる子たちが歩ってたりとか、今のトレンド感みたいなものが、時代性だと思うので、そういったものをこう吸収しながら、そういったものをちょっと黒く塗りつぶして落とす。
The kids show him what's cool, but it's the dark touches he adds that makes his items one of a kind. Currently Takahara's working on a new Sukajan idea.
見た感じがもうこういう風なフォルムのものだけども、襟を返すとタキシードクロスみたいになっててっていうことを考えたりとかっていうのはちょっとしますよね。こう返していくと。
スカジャンなんだけども、着こなしを変えるとタキシードになってしまうような、そのままパーティーに行けちゃうっていう、カジュアルをフォーマルに変える、いろんなちょっと手法を凝らすことも考えていて、も来年の冬ぐらいには出そうと思っている形で考えてます。
Since its days as a souvenir, the Sukajan has always reflected the times in which it was made and will continue to evolve as the times continue to change.
あの、ウサギとか初めて見ましたね。
Oh, that's true.
なんかやっぱトラとか竜とか強いもの、
Right, right, right.
タカとかのイメージがあったけど、あとあのスカルとかかっこいいなと思いました。
Yeah.
あのドット、遠くから見るとドットっぽく見えるけど、近くで見るとそのスカルが描かれてるとか、新しい感じだし、なんかあの今後出したいって言ってたタキシードっぽいスカジャンっていうのも見たことないから、
oh, yeah.
面白いなと思いました。
Yeah, he was saying you can wear it to a party and it wouldn't be weird.
ね、パーティーでもスカジャン着ていけるっていう、
はい、That's new, that's next.
新しい。
Okay, the first message is from Marine Croze from US, Midwest. What is the one thing you hope to try in life that you haven't yet?
一度やってみたいのが、スカイダイビングです。
Really? ほんま？
なんか結構バンジージャンプも興味があったんですけど、バンジージャンプってその一人で自分で行く勇気とか、高さとかもまあリアルな高さだと思うんですけど、
okay.
スカイダイビングってなんかやった人から聞くと、もう落ちてる感じしない、本当飛んでるみたいな感覚らしくて、なんかそういうのを聞いてすごい良かったよっていうし、あの後ろに先生みたいな人がついてくれるやつもあるし、
mm-hmm.
安全かなと思ってやってみたいです。鳥の気持ちになってみたい。
Oh, you want to feel like a bird, see what it feels like to fly.
エレイさん何かあります、やってみたいこと。
Me? Something I want? Not skydiving. I'm afraid to try anything that might kill me. I don't eat fugu. I don't eat kaki. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I might die.
Kaki?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It scares me. Yeah, so.
Kaki だ方がいいですよ。美味しいじゃん。だってフグなんて調理で出てくるから死なないですもん。自分でさばいたら危ないですけど。
Right. I don't know. Definitely not skydiving though.
まあね、でも確かに確率 100% とは言い切れないとかです。もし開かなかったらとかあるけど、
right, right, right. Small percentage.
まあでも死ぬまでにはやってみたいことはスカイダイビングですね。
OK, maybe I'll try. Next message from United Kingdom, Berkshire Reading, and the name is Martin Kachingwe. Dear Carrie, I enjoy learning about Japan from this show as well as your music. My question is, what are your favorite hobbies when you are not making music?
趣味
なかなか
ないんですよね、趣味という趣味が、
really?
でもやっぱ趣味っていうとおかしいけど、ショッピングですかね。お休みの日とかそこまで外に出るタイプじゃなくて、結構インドア派なんですけど、
okay.
でも定期的に絶対に行くのはショッピングは一人でも行くし、
oh, really? Alone?
一人で出かけるってなるとやっぱお買い物ですね。
Is it always clothing or do you buy, I don't know, other things too?
まあ基本的に洋服が多いですね。あと家具買ったりとか。
Okay. How many hours do you take for your clothes shopping?
全然もう1日行ったりとか、wow. 半日行ったりとか、一人でやることはそうですね。
Okay. What is the newest thing you bought lately?
ハンドクリーム買いました。
Okay, okay. It's getting cold and dry.
でもあの日本のドンキホーテって、uh-huh.種類がめちゃくちゃ豊富で、
really?
テスターが結構あるから、
oh,
こう匂いとか嗅いだり、つけ心地でいいやつがあったんで、
okay.
最近購入しました。
Good! Hand cream.
Hand cream.
Music and manga loving pop professor Ichio Nakamura. He was director of a Japanese rock band and a guest professor at MIT Media Laboratory. Here is his unique perspective about Japanese culture. Today's topic is stations!
Hello, I'm Ichie. Do you know which station in the world has the most passengers getting on and off the trains? It is Shinjuku Station in Tokyo. On average, 3.5 million people a day. Shibuya is the second busiest, and Ikebukuro is the third. All of them are stations in Tokyo. Surprisingly, there is also data that lists only Japanese stations for the top 23 busiest stations in the world. The Gare du Nord, the North Station in Paris, finally comes in at 24th, while the 25th is Taipei Station in Taiwan. Among the top 100, 83 of the stations are in Japan. The railway in Japan is amazing. Sophisticated technology has been introduced to the stations of Japan, such as automatic ticket gates. Automatic ticket gates first appeared in Japan in 1967. IC cars greatly changed the automatic ticket gate system.
Automatic ticket gates serve tens of millions of people every day in Japan. These days, 80% of train travelers use smart cards when going through the ticket gates. You can charge these cards at ticket vending machines and use them as often as you want. Once it's charged, just press it against this blue lit sign, and the gates will let you through. It only takes 0.2 seconds for the gates to open. This speed makes transferring between trains a smooth and smart process. For example, 9 train lines connect to Shibuya Station, the second most crowded station in the world. But with a smart card, you can get on and off every one of those lines without hassle. But these cards aren't just for trains. You can even use them to get on buses and even buy stuff from vending machines, station stalls, and convenience stores.
Stations in Japan also have another great feature, that is shops. Within the stations, there are various shops. Stations are located in the center of Japanese cities. And in the same buildings, there are often department stores and multiple restaurants.
Right opposite these ticket gates is, in fact, a department store. Recognize Shibuya Station? The department store is in the building right next to it. It's full of brand shops you'd find in any department store. There's also an entire floor dedicated to selling fresh food. And there are even restaurants offering high-quality fare.
Stations in Japan are not only for moving from one place to the other, but have now also become hubs for shopping and the service industry. Considering the depth of what is in offer, it is not possible to enjoy it all in one day. When you visit Japan, you should enjoy exploring the stations, but take care not to get lost. After all, there are many people and the stations are complicated.
And that's it for today's episode. How was it for you, Gary?
そうですね。やっぱスカジャンがその日本が結構発祥の地というか、あの古くからあるものっていうのも今日初めて知りましたし、なんかレプリカとヴィンテージを見比べても、やっぱその忠実に再現してるけど、レプリカの方はあの ちょっと新しさも入ってたりとか、ヴィンテージはヴィンテージでやっぱりレプリカと比べて重みがすごかったりとか、その違いも分かれて楽しかったです。
Right, right. Alright, so we'll see everybody next time.
うん。
バイバイ。
またね
We are accepting questions for Carrie through this website. If you are lucky, Carrie will answer them on the program. You will also receive Carrie's merchandise as a gift. The website also features lots of information on a variety of Japanese cultures. Check it out! This program was made possible by Asobi System.